What's up, Melanated family? This is your boy Harrison from Melanated Fathers TV, keeping you up to date with the latest news going on in our community. So please do me a favor, like I always say, hit that like button, hit that share button, subscribe to the Melanated Fathers TV YouTube family. If you ain't did that yet, you plan, you feel me? So let's get it going, man. I have some good news, but I wanted to kind of break down or have a conversation about why we're at this place currently. You know what I mean? Because a 39-year-old black man named Dante Williams has been hired as the first black head coach for the USC football team, right? So hats off to that brother, because this is definitely an accomplishment. Any football coach who's been doing it for a while, I'm assuming that their main goal is to get to the head coach status, especially at a school as pristine as USC. This has been a football powerhouse and seen as such for a very long time. So this is a great opportunity for the brother. 39-year-old black man Dante Williams is the new head coach of USC. Now, it is an interim position, so they could be looking for somebody else to fill that position. But for now, the brother is the head coach, right? And, you know, he has coaching experience. He's been coaching for over like 12 years. He's worked at other schools like Oregon, Arizona, San Jose State, Nebraska. So the brothers definitely put his time in. He was a former recruiter, associate head coach. You know what I mean? Their past, or the head coach they just fired, his name is Clay Helton, a white man, of course, and he was fired recently. You know what I mean? So despite, and here's the thing, man, we always talk about the lack of representation in the coaching ranks when it comes to these sports. And the primary reason that I think about it that way, because it's not like I'm looking at it that way when it comes to soccer or hockey or some sport that isn't predominantly black, right? But when we look at football, when we look at basketball, the athletes are predominantly black. And basically, you know, even though there's a large black population of athletes, for example, like the elite Power Five conferences in college football, black coaches are still like disproportionately assigned. You know what I mean? And I think like a lot of things that goes on in our country that has to do with race relations, you know, sometimes we're seen as being just athletes and physical and, you know, being touted for our athletic prowess, where many people outside of our community don't really look to us for our intellect. And these are like age-old stereotypes that we still deal with today, right? Even when we look at like the quarterback. The quarterback has always been seen as a pristine position, someone who's the leader, someone who has to think on his feet. And for whatever reason, well, shit, racism and the institutionalized racism that we've had to deal with in this country, there's been like these negative stereotypes associated with our intellect. You know, I think it's been that way since slavery, since we've actually gotten here. We've been seen as, by certain people, as stupid or not as smart as other folks. When, I mean, if you do your history, we were the first people here. You know what I mean? So sometimes just hearing that kind of shit, it just makes you go, You know what I mean? So shout out to the brother Dante Williams. Again, 39-year-old black man who's the first coach, the first black coach at USC in their 140-year history, which just seems like, damn, right? I'm kind of getting tired of hearing the first, like we're the first doctor in this field, or the first person to go to moon in this field. You know what I mean? So I'm getting tired of hearing the first for black people, but we have to break down these walls. If we're going to be in this country, I think that still needs to happen. Even though it's sad and we contribute so much to culture and to the fabric of this country, it shouldn't be too many institutions where we're just now getting into. But that's just the country that's just the fabric of this country that we live in, y'all. So we have to be aware of that kind of shit. You feel me? So shout out to that brother. Hopefully this sets a precedent. I'm always trying to look at things on more from a positive note. I mean, you know, it's 140 years, but when college football first got it popping, you know, it was pretty much all white guys. So that makes sense to me that the coaches were white, because it was a representation of the players. But now that the players are pretty much all damn black, it's a travesty that we don't have more black coaches in the NFL, especially when if you watch sports, you'll see a lot of white head coaches. They get fired and hired all the time. Like, these motherfuckers switch jobs like they switch draws. They get fired from somewhere, get hired somewhere else. You know what I mean? So these are all barriers that we have to break down. And I hate that certain black people have to be the first and take all the ridicule and all the criticism. But, you know, that's the country that we live in, family, and we have to get used to that to a degree. But I think things are definitely changing when it comes to institutions like that. We just have to keep pushing for it and being aware of it and not being afraid to speak about it either. You know what I mean? So shout out to the brother Dante Williams. What do y'all think? Do y'all think he gonna keep the job? Do y'all even think there's a problem with the disparity with black coaches in the NFL or the NBA or the college ranks? You feel me? So let's talk about it. This is your boy Harrison, man. Melanated Fathers TV. Like the video, subscribe to the network, share the video. I'm out.